We are starting to see some great games come back to the map, but this is one of the coolest I've ever seen. This game is going to ship early next year from Bungie, and this is the first time anybody has ever seen it. It's the first time they've debuted it. And so I'm very happy to welcome on the stage Jason Jones, who is the co-founder of Bungie and the Halo project lead. Halo is the name of this game, and we're going to see for the first time Halo. Welcome, Jason.
Thanks, Steve. Yep. Everything you're about to see is being rendered in real time on a Macintosh using OpenGL.
Oh my god!
So you didn't know we were gonna start this far back.
So this is the spawning.
This is Attack of the Clones.
Hold on a second. Are those like newer guys or are those the old guys?
Those are the super old, like 100 poly guys.
Like, yeah, 100 poly.
Hey, that looks like the back of my dog.
Okay, so this is Sheik, Rob, and Paul, and Marty making sound effects.
Hello.
Oh, we're supposed to make sound effects.
Oh, hold on a second. No.
Wait.
I'll make the sound effects.
Okay, so this is. This is the first
This looks like myth.
Oh yeah. Oh, well, God. Of yeah. course that because that's what it was. This it's is this is engine. Dance.
Dance on.
Look at that real cool in-game tool on the top right corner there. We used to have really cool stuff like that, and yeah. Jason decided to say, hey, you know what? Let's not give any artists any cool stuff.
You can move the tank.
Yeah.
Jones.
And there's like one of the old busted up bunkers that...
Oh, now, was that made out of like igloo blocks? Beautiful.
No, I think it was just busted up.
Okay.
Man, where'd you get this bill, dude? This is like...
Oh, look, it's a horseshoe crab tank.
Yeah, it's the horseshoe crab tank. There's like the magical floating...
Is it the Hummer?
And the Humvee?
Yeah, the Hummer.
The horseshoe crab tank.
Yeah.
That's the first version of the Warthog, I guess, huh?
Yes.
Heavy
yeah.
trooper.
Yeah. Is that before you? That's before you, Sheik,
right? Yeah. Yeah. I came in right after. I remember coming in for an interview, and I'm like, whoa, this is kind of cool. Third person. Like, you know, sci-fi action adventure or something?
Yeah, we're like, wrong.
But
obviously,
she kinda...
made all the difference.
Like, those aliens look like crabs.
What happened to this tank?
Well,
tank?
There it is. I mean, it's right there. And that's where it stays.
That's
cool. There it is.
Oh, here we go. This is the
Army Men.
Army Men. There's the old version of
that's pretty cool.
The ghost.
Yes, yeah, so the one right to the left. Corner in the gray, right next to the Jeep.
Oh, hey, look,
yeah. There's another. Now we're out on the road. Who thought this was going to be cool?
Jones.
Oh, okay.
I mean, this isn't Halo, dude. Stop
around.
Showing me this old PC game
this
stuff.
Is,
come on, man. Let's go.
Hey, wow, the UI looks kind of cool.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's the
yeah.
First... Man, this is really, really old.
This is like, so what? This was like a month before you started, Chief?
Yeah, something like that.
So that would be like 2 months before I started.
Man, I remember seeing that and I'm like, holy crap, this is some awesome effects, man. I wish I can work in this game.
Fire effect. Oh.
What? That's like glass breaking
bag
up.
Bag of broken glass.
Oh, here we go. This is what I saw when I came in.
Oh, and there's the old helicopter.
Come on, man, let's go.
See, how long...
God.
It took me minutes to figure out how to make it.
There we go.
There we're going. What year is this now?
This is
1948.
Perk.
Yeah.
Palm trees.
Back in Marty's day.
Hey.
Oh.
Hey, look, there's no sound effects when you hit. I mean, there's nothing. No effects when you hit the water. It's the same thing as in Halo. Yeah.
We used to have watercraft.
Blood wake.
What see, it's hell? Cool when because back then when you get into vehicles, you go underneath them.
No, it's like so dual. Disappear. It's like dual. It's like the dual carrot craft.
Didn't we just port this code directly to the
see?
Blood wake?
See,
guys?
There you go. You just
oh,
popped out.
Oh God.
Hey, we had detail objects back then.
What detail objects are you talking
there,
about?
Look on the ground. See. Wow.
Oh! What the.
Oh, I thought I hit that guy.
Yeah.
No, what you
yeah,
see
I'm sure
here?
You did.
No, it's seriously, this is what 1998.
This is 98.
98.
I think so. Oh, actually,
no, it was before that. Like this is, I think this is still back in the Halsted office, man.
This is 98. I've seen
like
this.
Yoshi's Island
when I started.
Or something.
This is.
But I'm just saying, I think this is earlier than
the 98.
The 98.
No, oh, this is
the old
this is the beginning.
Oh, the old broken Halo.
Look at the
broken
Halo.
The little railroad track. There's a railroad
that's
track
a little prelude to what happens in the future.
I think it's O-scale.
The right, one? Yeah.
Oh, see, that's
oh,
the
there's
old...
the Warthog.
Oh, man,
it's
look
like
at the old stealth
like
tank that never got in the game.
Yeah.
I remember driving.
Well, look, I mean, the guy still has the assault rifle across his shoulders.
Yeah, that still looks cool, man. I don't know why everybody says
that's a good idea.
Yeah. There's oop, the blind wolf.
Blind wolf.
Oh, let's all have a moment of silence for the blind wolf.
There he goes.
Oh,
get moving.
Yeah.
It's a chocobo.
Beautiful chicken legs.
Isn't this from Final Fantasy?
Yeah. Yeah.
Man, we don't want to publish this game, dude.
Well, see, we're going to self-publish. So.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Must be hard to write a rubber chicken.
Oh, see, no, it's not fun anymore. It's getting too close to the real one.
Oh, right, there's the...
What build is this for?
With what is that, like
that's
a
the
64 by 64 map on the Warthog or something?
Oh, man.
So yeah,
Rob, you're going to have some nice guns to look at again coming up.
They're the best.
So that looks like a Warthog.
It's a Warthog.
I mean, the textures are so low res. I mean, that's cool. You know?
Yeah, I think we're using 128s or something at that point.
Man, we're limited by technology. That
sucks.
Look at the frame rate. There's nothing on the screen. What's it drawing?
Oh, yes. The old
everything.
The old Sullivan textures.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the cathedral on
good
Halo.
Inspiration.
Hey, you notice now that everything else in the world is like dropped out, you can actually
run faster.
Yeah. Oh, nice, nice head right through the geometry. What a load of.
Well, we got rid of that whole clipping problem. I know that.
Yeah. Whoa.
That people probably want to know why we switched from third person to first person.
Why did we?
Yeah.
Well, why did
we? Oh, why did we? Because Jason.
Jason again.
Yeah, it's all this damn Jason, solid. Man. He's not here, is he? Yeah, that Jason, I tell you.
Well, he was the one that was dead set against first person for a long time.
Yeah, and then
right?
He's like, hey, wait, we can't make third person work. Hey, let's change it back.
You know, that's what happens.
The truth comes out.
That's what happens when your lead is a crack addict.
Oh, dang.
I've seen him.
Jason, I didn't say
that. That was Paul Russell.
Paul Russell? Okay.
Paul Russell. Former Bungie employee.
I'll pack my stuff.
Oh, well, hey, look. Here's the control room.
The old control room.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy, I have a sense of awe.
Dude, this is cool.
It is.
Yeah, a sense of awe.
Hey, we should try and talk real hip and stuff, because... Never mind.
Dude, this room is really
dude,
rad.
That's dope.
It's rad.
It's
that's
dope.
Tight.
Yeah, it's thick, tight. Man. It's thick. G.
What's up at the...
Oh, yeah, this is the first time
we have
a
big mirror.
Mirror,
right?
The big mirror.
Yeah. Yeah, we got a lot of use out of that in the real Halo, huh? Didn't we?
Did Marcus have anything to do with this room?
Like, ooh, what? Oh, nice. Oh, yeah, Manhorse Demon.
Oh, you know whose name that? That's Matt Seger's name.
Yeah. Right.
Okay, are we done now? No. Oh,
here we go. This is Macworld
99.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I wonder is if we actually have
now it gets boring.
Tracers on there.
Oh, the multiple reticles. That was kind of cool.
Well, it's the only way to actually hit what you're aiming at in third person.
Right, in third person, yeah, yeah.
Oh, man.
So we actually tried to play
multiplayer
on this thing with third person once, and then it's just impossible.
It's just, well, it turned into a, like, grenade juggling act.
Yeah, just because you can't aim for crap.
Yeah. Now, does that, that actually had, like, the disintegrating belt in it?
Huh? It went in?
Yeah, it created, like, twice as many particles as it
really
needed to be.
Yeah.
It had casings and the belt came flying out of there.
And here we go inside.
Oh, that was
inside.
Nice.
Yeah, I remember we had trouble transitioning between the exterior engine
room.
And the interior engine.
Yeah.
This is the old control room.
Well, but I mean, compared to what we just saw.
Yeah.
It's newer
than that one.
Look at all that.
It's getting close.
Hologram thing.
What happens when you paint it?
Yeah, look at that hologram. Wow.
What happens when you paint a million textures and they all go in the toilet?
Yeah, none of this stuff ever got used in the original one. Man, that's so depressing.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, there's the old, that was the old alien sniper rifle, the plasma sniper rifle.
Yeah.
There's the old AR.
Ooh. And there's, oh, I thought that was a chicken leg for a second.
The
flaming turkey leg.
Oh, and the sword, yeah.
Jason X.
You know, here's the anti-air rocket launcher. Mm-hmm.
Cool. It's got that magic pocket that can fill up with anything.
Yeah, there it goes.
It's going to explode.
Yeah. Look at my imagination.
Oh, and there's
that is cool. Chain gun.
Yeah.
Hey, didn't you borrow some of that for the flamethrower?
I did. There's the pistol.
Look at all the cool weapons we had.
There's
before.
There's the anti-armor rocket.
How much did we get to keep from all this? Like 5?
Yeah. Which one is that? That's the shotgun.
Right, yeah.
That's the
shotgun. Shotgun too.
Yeah, it's all right. Oh, the SMG. Holy, what the hell?
Nice effect.
It's a fire hazard.
That was Shikai's effect.
It's a...
Ooh. Oh, and there's the old shovel.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sniper rifle.
Sniper rifle.
Shovel?
Yeah.
Because of the
wood.
The spear gun. Oh, my God. That was the
now,
huge,
that's
like,
for the sea creatures.
Now, yeah. I'll bet they won't have it in here.
Yeah,
but
the sea creatures
we're
going to have in the game. That never resulted.
I'll bet that we.
Is that Marty?
They won't show it in here, but it was a lot of fun when the
what's that?
The spear gun would cover. We used to cover guys and spears.
It's a drum key, can't you?
A drum key. It is a drum key. My drummer always lost his drum.
That was cool.
Look at all these cool alien weapons we had.
Oh, man.
What's that?
That was
like a boring device.
Yeah.
I mean, not boring. Boring.
Here's the old.
That was
big old.
That's neat. I love that kickback.
There's the gravity wrench.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see?
Yeah, instead of fixing things, it just blows it up.
It's the jaws of life, I think.
That's for putting a monkey wrench in. It works.
Man, that goes a long way.
Yeah, there's the
What is that? Is that sniper rifle?
That's the sniper rifle.
Yeah,
that's
the alien sniper, sniper rifle.
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Boy, are you going to actually shoot that thing or just sit around? Oh, oh well.
Halo used to be cool.
Yeah. Again, what's that?
Who thought that was a good particle effect? That's what I want to know.
Hey, man. I'm in the room, Marty.
I like the UI, though.
Oh, see, so yes. The whole thing with Chucky's love. Oh, well, I guess we can't explain that one.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is closer. Actually had the map up in the upper.
Mm. Oh, this is E3 one.
This
E3.
Is the E3. Right. E3 2000.
Is
yep.
This is still PC, though.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, I kind of like the old ones where the reflection maps weren't circular. It was just planar. That was cooler.
Boy, that's when the artist knew how to draw skies, though.
What?
Oh, sorry.
Hey, man, don't kick Marcus when he's not here defending himself.
It's always better to kick him when he is here.
I like that sky better.
Cool.
There's nothing to say about this one. Everybody's seen this already.
Yeah, but
all the old ones are the funny ones.
We want to know your feelings about it.
I feel moist.
Oh, man.
I thought there wasn't going to be any.
No, okay, my forehead.
Okay.
damn, sweating.
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's bad.
You guys have dirty, dirty minds.
Oh, man.
That's going to be edited.
Hey, how come I feel the cannon off the back?
Good.
What do you? Well,
Rob.
Hey, it wasn't my decision.
What?
Like we would have had like 30 different guns in that.
That's
thing
right.
If it would have been up to me. Yeah.
Go in the water. Go in the water.
Well, you know, it's like come out to Microsoft. And, oh, and by the way, you only have 5 months to make your game.
Cool.
Well, so, it was either that or never release it. And yeah. Then, go look for other jobs.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, look at that collision,
that
huh?
Kind of cool.
Yeah.
Damn, man.
Ooh, oh, frame rate.
Who's driving this?
Is
this
wait. Why is there a cursor on the far left? Oh, is that? I never seen it.
That's a particle effect.
Yeah.
No. The far left.
That's telling you. Yeah. That's telling you where the gun is pointed.
Huh. Yeah. All right, man. Here we are.
Yeah.
Everybody out.
Yeah.
Start fighting.
See, as you can tell, there's no AI at all. Everything was scripted in E3.
What? What? Are you saying E3 was smoke and mirrors?
It was
I think it's time we let the truth out there, Marty.
It was all done in Max. 3D Studios, 3D software. And,
in fact, we have puppeteers.
But you're right about the collisions.
It was all done AI. With puppets.
Yeah. We outsourced it to...
Blizzard.
A post-production house.
To Henson.
Yeah.
Post effects.
What is this? What are we doing?
Inside.
No, you're running down. The shaft.
Oh, man, it's over.
What, this is it? Sure, there's a lot of unlocked doors for something that...
Oh, shut up, God. Marty.
Hey, so there's Sheik and myself and Marcus.
Yeah, but no me. Together. Way to go. It's all right.
It's all about you, Jim. Hey, everybody. So I'm Jason. I'm one of the co-founders of Bungie and the lead on Halo. I've got Joe Staten with me here. He's our director of cinematics. Joe's done some pretty cool Halo movies of the PC version of the game over the last 2 years for you guys. We're going to put him on the spot this time, do something a little bit different, get him to actually play Halo on the Xbox. And we're pretty much going to let it speak for itself.
So. Great. Thanks, Jason. It's really nice not to be showing you a movie today, and although it makes me very nervous to actually play this for you, I am going to be playing Halo in the flesh, on the Xbox. On behalf of the whole Halo team, thanks a lot for coming, and welcome to Halo on the Xbox. Is locked in a life or death struggle with a group of aliens known as the Covenant. The Covenant have destroyed our colony worlds, their forces, they're unstoppable. To lead the Covenant away from Earth, a ship of human soldiers makes a blind jump to a forgotten corner of the galaxy, where they crash on Halo. An ancient ring artifact 10,000 kilometers in diameter locked in orbit between an obscure planet and its moon. And this is Halo. And this is you. An elite military unit, you are the last of your kind. Trained to fight with any weapon, attack in any vehicle, you are mankind's most sophisticated piece of military hardware. Linking together with other survivors from the crash, you begin a guerrilla war against the Covenant army that followed you to Halo. Whichever side, human or alien, first uncovers the secrets of Halo, will find something that will alter the course of the war. Humanity's fate is in your big, green, armored hands.
Yeah!
Thanks a lot. So that's Halo. Come see us at the Pavilion.
Woo!
I'm one of the monks. I also write the music for Halo and work on the sound design. I'm Marty O'Donnell, and this is my little friend.
All right. Bigger than you think, O'Donnell. Joseph State and I do all the cinematics and otherwise pester Marty.
Yeah, all the time. But we have to work together as a team because what is visuals without audio?
That's true. Good point. And this is an excellent example of just that, right,
this opening,
that relationship,
this
Marty.
Opening somewhat cutscene, but you still have control of the camera, but action is still happening on the screen.
Hey, this actually happens a lot in the first level, which is what we're seeing now. The player is actually taking camera control away from me,
right,
which makes me nervous. But at the
right.
same time, sets up really cool cinematic moments that we've just essentially
you know,
set up different things that are going to happen in the environment, be they explosions that trigger when you run by them, or guys that run up to you and have something important to say, little in-level cinematic
Every
moments
piece
that
of
are very
shrapnel
cool.
has its own metallic hit sound when it hits, and you know where it's hitting because you have surround sound on, everybody, right?
Don't badger them, Marty.
Oh,
if they
well,
have
sorry.
The system, they'll use it.
It's a good system.
But really, this whole first part of the game, when you're on your ship, the Pillar of Autumn, this big, massive, kilometer-long cruiser, you are essentially being boarded by the aliens, and we really wanted to give the player in real time that feeling of panic, terror, as the aliens tear through your ship.
And Mendoza.
Mendoza, actually, the Marines each have unique personalities and names.
And look at that throw. That's a great grenade throw.
Great moment. So every time you meet a new Marine, he's going to... Well, maybe have something interesting to say, but he's going to have a unique voice, and that voice will stay with him throughout his lifetime.
Which is brief.
If you're trying to protect them. Right?
Oh.
And this is a part of an insertion cinematic, what we call the cinematic moments at the beginning of a level, where we introduce the level to the player, show them the environment they're going to fight in, maybe show them a preview of the enemies they're going to face, that sort of thing.
And hear the ambient background of the birds and the wind and the Covenant dropship coming from far away, mm-hmm. and the music swelling as you see the sun.
And this is actually a pretty challenging
course,
environment.
You're not hearing that at this moment. You're hearing us.
Right, sure.
But, okay, just pretend.
But a pretty challenging environment to actually try to create cinematics for and add sounds to, just because it is so big and imposing.
And a giant waterfall over to your right, which is echoing off the cliffs. And it really, truly is echoing because we have environmental modeling, digital signal processing chip on the Xbox, which we can set to all sorts of environmental models. Like this is a huge room with a really big echo. And this is the Arnold Schwarzenegger shot.
I don't know why you refer to that as the Schwarzenegger shot.
Don't you mean
when
that
it's
movie?
Clearly a sort of Godard.
Godard.
Anyways,
yeah.
That's another insertion cinematic, again, showing the player who they're going to fight, where they're going to fight them.
Yep.
And if you're quick enough on this level, you can actually steal one of the Banshees, this alien flying vehicle, from the aliens before they're able to get into it.
And to show you how big it is, I think if you were to get in this Banshee and just fly straight across to the other side, it still takes you like 20 seconds.
It's a really big
And every
big
one of those little plasma hits, when it hits the wall, has its own little unique burning sound, which
actually,
was partially my mouth noise, by the way, for those of you who didn't know that.
That's gross, dude.
Yeah, okay.
But
mouth
I mean,
noises are good for games, trust me. Because you know what, everybody
for
else...
something else,
hey,
too!
Hey!
Edit that out.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, so where are we? Look at those hooves that these guys have. Those creatures are great. You know, whenever you kill one of those creatures, you should definitely get up close and just look at it for a while, because it's unbelievable what it looks like.
Actually, we don't really spend a lot of time luxuriating on and actually showing you the aliens in the cinematics,
right.
which is too bad, because every little piece of them has a sound when it clanks, this hunter's armor, his shield,
right.
for example.
Even when he's breathing, he makes sounds, and it's tied directly to the way his idle animations work and then his action animations.
My favorite sound I think I've heard that you've created so far, Marty, though, is when you sneak up behind one of these hunters
yeah.
and you melee attack them in the game,
yeah.
and then, I'm not going to spoil it, but you just got to listen to the sound they make when they die, when they fall forward and die.
Gabonk.
It's good stuff. Think watermelon
yeah,
wrapped up in
go.
A big thing of tinfoil.
Right, baseball bat.
In the ground.
Yeah. So this is good here. You got the sniper rifle. You get
uh-huh.
in close.
Hey,
does
Marty,
this remind you
this,
of anything?
Does this look familiar, Marty? Oh,
yeah, but I was on that other end.
Oh, wait, if that didn't look familiar, does this look familiar?
No.
Oh, Martin!
What? Oh!
Ooh. Yeah, that should remind you of every single time you ever faced me in multiplayer, muchacho.
I know. But that's because I actually spend my time working rather than playing till I get good.
Hey, if you listen really close, I think you can hear the ice creaking.
Yeah, and the snowflakes actually hitting the ice.
Uh-huh.
Every detail is in this game.
And the cool thing about, well, I mean, this is just cool, right?
This is totally cool.
I'm sort of mesmerized by it. Take that, dang!
Yeah.
And actually, the first time I saw this, yeah, the ghost actually coming out of the thing. That's great.
The physics are really fun to work with. So when we actually attach sounds and they work with the actual physics of the environment, that means the sounds do things that we weren't even planning on them to do once you start working with them in the environment. So as the hovercraft gets nearer and further away and bounces, the sound actually responds and crash. There you go. Sound of metal crashing into metal.
What you're saying, Marty, is it's all about putting the puzzle pieces into place and then just letting the player go.
Letting Jason Jones make it happen.
There you go.
He's the man.
There you go.
See, I know who's the kiss. Oh, sorry. And there's the tank that looks broken, but it's not. See, because he starts it up. And working on engine sounds for these things is also a blast because the engines... You can tell exactly what's coming at you from behind. Something's coming at you from behind. You can tell some little creature walking up to you or some huge tank driving up to you. You don't even have to see it.
A lot of the time in Halo, when you're going through these big environments, we are built in moments of transition. This, though we haven't created the cinematic for yet, is going to be one of the situations where you come into a new environment that's huge and massive and you want to show it in third person and figuring out a way to pull back and say, hey,
this is how big.
This is how big and cool it is.
Kaboom!
Thank you. look, it's the blind wolf.
Beloved blind wolf.
That was back when you could ride it.
Yeah, you could actually mount the thing and ride it. AI couldn't handle it on the AI side, couldn't flock them, couldn't fit them into gameplay.
Oh, it's nothing on our end.
No.
It's always the programmer.
We had it all.
Hey, the Drenal.
Yeah, hey. Drenal was a big deal.
The Hulk.
Giant boss character. Always thought the Covenant kept this thing, you know, all tied up and enraged.
Right.
And it would bring it out during the frontline battle.
It would have been a cool boss character.
I think he was just too damn big. Yeah.
Good vehicle smasher, it would have been good.
Yeah.
That was the special purpose sniper guy, right?
We wanted him to have his arms used as like a tripod, and he can actually flip left to right, like side to side, so without having to switch weapons or something.
We had him
silly.
Being able to hang from trees as well and do some weird stuff like that.
He got pretty far too. We actually textured him and got into the game and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It took that long to figure out that.
Yeah.
He's a piece of crap.
This is the engineer.
We got this into the game.
It's actually
fully modeled,
one.
Textured.
Yeah.
It was a technological savvy character that would rip apart technology and idiot
savant.
Consume it for the Covenant. This is probably the weirdest character I've seen in our sketchbook.
Marcus said we needed a character that was more menacing because everyone of our characters looked too.
We needed
kitty-like.
Something more monstery.
Yeah.
Monster-like.
We were just trying to go have a physique that's like biped, but doesn't behave like a biped. So you have all these parts that are missing and all these limbs that are extra limbs.
This guy's cool.
I like this guy. He was supposed to carry his weapon under his belly.
The beginnings of the hunter, I think.
Hey,
there you go, Rob.
It's the what
gator,
was it?
Dog? Doberman.
Doberman gator or the
And then the keel bug. Which was my idea for cleaning up bodies on the battlefield. It would a few of them would fly in and cut the body into sections and fly off.
I like the wing where it actually distorts.
It made no sense.
Oh. That's cool.
I think it was a strike fighter, right? It was like strike a defensive fighter for the Earth space.
Well, it just didn't fit into our gameplay either. We didn't have
a purpose
for this kind of thing.
Less cinematics.
Yeah, it'd be a cinematic only thing.
We needed more of a Blackhawk type vehicle, which also got dropped. Dude, I so wanted this vehicle to get into the game.
The doozy.
Precursor to the doozy.
Yeah.
This didn't make any sense.
Didn't that thing eventually wind up getting a gun on the back of it, or?
No, two people got one in the front, one in the back.
And then one guy facing backwards.
Yeah.
The nausea seat.
Hovercraft were kind of a strange thing back then, especially ones that we needed to remain stationary at a certain altitude. That we had a very difficult time with some of those. It would have taken a long time for us to tune the engine physics to make it work right.
This is disappointing as well.
Yeah. We have tried so hard to get this thing into the game. We had effects, model, we even reiterated it.
Yeah.
Rob did for Halo 2.
We built it. The most difficult model to build that I did in Halo was the most difficult rebuild for Halo 2.
Yep. Looked beautiful too. Sure, it sucks. Yeah, it's all this good stuff we want to get into the game, but you know, that's part of making games.
Started off with just three of us. We were at that time making what we thought was going to turn out to be a myth type clone with a sci-fi skin on it.
They were doing Blam, which was the code name for this other game that they were working on.
We had a huge map for a continuous RPG. Then before that, we had an RTS.
We had no idea what the game was going to be. I had no idea. You know, I was just there to do concepts.
It was pretty generic sci-fi. You had your typical military forces, tanks, jeeps, that kind of thing, and some armored guys.
We did a lot of thinking about what it meant to be an action game, and could an action game be a real-time strategy game? And the answer was no.
We wanted a sci-fi character, a guy in a suit who can go from Earth to space. I wouldn't have to worry about him changing clothes. And he just needed to look like a space marine.
Oh God, what do we call him? Something like the super soldier.
And then, you know, we started to move the camera and closer to the character.
What if we put ourselves in this character? What if we became that character?
Sorry for the quick thaw, Master Chief. Things are a little hectic right now.
Those are the moments where things start to come together. It's Marcus saying like, no, we're going first person because this is more fun.
I don't think we would have captured as much of the audience had we stayed in third person.
Chief, Cortana says to get to the bridge, double quick.
Those are the ideas and the decisions that really change the course of a game and a company.
All you greenhorns who wanted to see Covenant up close, this is gonna be your lucky day.
Suddenly we had this opportunity to tell a little piece of a story. I remember Joe coming to me and all he said to me was, that's it, ancient, epic, alien. So he just gave me those three words. And I thought, okay, well, I'll just try combining something that does that. Came up with the pounding drums, cellos, monks, alien voice. Showed it to the guys on a Monday morning, and then they got on a plane to go to New York and show it at Macworld the next day.
This is one of the coolest I've ever seen. And we're gonna see, for the first time, Halo.
Which really went over big.
They were, you know, making games for the Mac, which, you know, was still a pretty small install base at that time. But, you know, Bungie wanted to, I think, do pretty ambitious games. And, you know, to fund the games of that caliber is not easy to do.
One day my phone rings telling me that Bungie's kind of in financial trouble and that they're talking to some people about potentially being acquired.
It was going to be really important to Microsoft to have games for the Xbox. That's what was going to make or break it. And so, you know, we called up Ed Fries and said, maybe we should talk.
That was a great call to get. I mean, it was definitely a time when I was open to that kind of a conversation. I had money to spend. I desperately needed content for this new platform that was going to be showing up in less than 2 years.
We knew that there were some financial struggles at that time. There were some strange dudes in black suits walking around the office weeks prior to that. And so we knew something was going on.
I'd been there for a couple months, and then I get called into Alex's office, and he's like, so, we might be moving to Seattle. And I was like, oh God, I just signed a lease. This is a group that where I respected their talent, because I had seen their previous games. I mean, I probably would have been interested in them just for the team, but the fact that they had this Halo thing that they were trying to figure out was a plus.
Ed came into me one day and said, I want you to go talk to Jason and Alex and tell them it's all gonna be okay when we buy them.
Greed. Pure and simple, cashed it in, sold our souls, came out here. I mean, if you're gonna sell your soul, Seattle's a pretty nice place to do it.
Back in the 90s, Microsoft had an evil empire quality to them, and the idea that they were going to Microsoft was, oh no, they're selling out.
That turning point of us going from PC games to console was, I mean, it was gigantic. I think it was a giant gamble.
Bungie, I think, presented a good opportunity for them, but it was incredibly risky too.
One of the main pulls for the team to move into Microsoft was to be a part of creating the Xbox and making a game that really used it.
Jason said it best, I think. He said that Microsoft is building the biggest cannon in the world, and they're pointing it right at Sony, and we can be the bullet in that cannon, and we can make a really big impact on the course of the game industry.
All right! Yeah, that's cool.
We got very excited about the opportunity to define a platform. And to define a franchise that would be important to the platform.
Everybody in the office was pissed off because we liked being independent and, you know, kind of the man sort of thing. And then now we go to the console, it's like, hey there, man. He's like shaking your hand instead of raising your fist up. It was exciting as well as terrifying.
I had this nice spot in this building picked out for them, and I thought they were gonna love it, and they hated it. You know, it was typical Microsoft office, which Microsoft people think are great. Bungie guys looked at me and like, this is awful. This is exactly the opposite of what we want. You know, we want a big open space and just mow down all these walls in this section.
People just couldn't fathom being at Microsoft.
I remember Ed complaining at one point that even he didn't have a key to get into the Bungie area.
Welcome aboard, Master Chief. Ready for dust off.
The challenge that I think Halo faces is that it was, you know, trying to do a first-person shooter on a console platform.
One of the biggest challenges was making a shooter that really felt right and worked right on a controller.
Yeah, I mean, originally you had to struggle with it really being the first FPS that we were trying to get into on a console.
On a controller.
With the Duke. It was huge. Coming from PC first-person shooters, it just really felt...
Different.
The reality of actually shipping on a console, there was a lot of pressure there. And we didn't have anything running on that console at all.
When I joined, the AI for Halo was about 3 source files and a big block comments at the top that were just Jason's log of him frantically trying to get something, anything, up and running. Jamie Griesmer and myself, we just sat down and worked on 2 signature encounters. One was the beach on Silent Cartographer, which is the classic kind of wave advancing encounter, and the other was the classic defensive encounter. We really only had 1 shot at it because we weren't going to have time to go back and scrap the AI system, so we just knew we had to get it right.
We had a lot of content to build, gameplay experiences to create. So all these grand ideas we had of this huge open world experience quickly dissipated.
Bungie has always had a way of finding out what's important in a particular game style and throwing away the extraneous stuff.
Going to see if we can save some soldiers. Roger, Cortana.
I think there were a very small group of people who felt like Halo would be the defining game of the Xbox.
There were a lot of other games that were getting a lot more attention, really, than Halo. Malice, Munch's Odyssey, racing game.
I think they put a lot of their bets on this game called Azeroth. I don't know if anybody remembers that.
Master Chief was certainly a part of it, but he wasn't the guy.
It wasn't preordained that it was going to be Halo. Halo earned that right, you know, by being one of the best titles in development at the time.
Good luck, Master Chief.
On Halo, one of the moments that always sticks out in my mind was once we actually got B-30 up and running and you could play it.
Just something as simple as driving the Warthog on B-30, which was fun. That was a defining game experience.
They brought me in. Here's a prototype Xbox, here's a prototype controller, and here's this game called Halo. And he said, you know, Bungie. I'm like, who? Mac game? Are you joking? He gives it to me, and I'm sort of staring around. I'm like, oh, wow, this is amazing. Like, I just, and all it was the B-30 running around on the beach and just shooting stuff. I was like, this is fantastic.
There was such an energizing moment. I said, oh, you know, this is what we're actually making. All of a sudden, the team just kind of got traction and kicked in and started going at high gear.
At that time, there were 3 teams. There was the Halo team, there was still the Phoenix team, and then there was the Oni team.
They owe it all to the Oni team because before we came up from San Jose, they had no multiplayer, so the multiplayer designer and the multiplayer programmer came from the Oni team.
Getting closer and closer to the deadline for Halo, each one of those teams ended up getting absorbed into the Halo team because there was just no way we were gonna make it.
We almost cut multiplayer out of it a few days before we had to ship the build because it wasn't really working that well. You know, we were having arguments about how many people can actually connect a box together. We're like, yeah, maybe in college dorms people will do it, but who's gonna carry a TV to their friend's house?
Everybody was pushing to keep multiplayer in, but none of us knew just what it would mean.
That was the first time I had felt like I was part of a team that was moving inexorably towards something.
The awesome thing was watching the game being built.
I probably wouldn't have made the Covenant guys so colorful, but that was a request from Jason. Shinier, brighter, more color. I'm like, dude, you're f***ing nuts, man. This thing's like rainbow, it's horrible. Obviously it worked. I mean, he knows it from a gameplay perspective, like, this is what makes games tick.
Sleep well?
No thanks to your driving, yes.
So you did miss me. I think I auditioned with a British dialect, and then I auditioned with just a vaguely Spanishy, Frenchy, German sound. And I don't know if it was Marty or who said, just do your own voice. get in your lower register and give that to us.
Halo, it's finished.
No, I think we're just getting started.
Halo was incredibly unique because there wasn't anything like it. This sort of perfect storm of music and art and universe design.
You could see that someone had really thought through a world. And the greatest stories, especially in the sci-fi realm, are coherent visions. The continuity comes from an underlying vision that shines through.
Halo was an action game, and it put you in this world where you could be the most powerful actor in this rich physical simulation. It gave you this ability to become competent and then show your competence to your friends competitively or to your friends cooperatively.
I'll never forget this. I get like a headshot on Zach and I'm like, sit the f- down. And there's like applause. And I turn around and there's a group of people who are watching. And before I know it, like we have this f-ing line. And people were like coming in, playing their 10 minutes of Slayer, just getting right back in line.
Multiplayer and Halo just go hand in hand.
Now they get it. The multiplayer was the thing. Oh, yeah!
Everybody should get Halo. That's the main thing.
Definitely.
Launch titles that don't suck. What a concept.
Oh, sweet.
Got here early. It's a good thing.
Yeah.
Got liquor. Got a...